So see, here we have a question number 2. Three cubes of size 60 mm, 40 mm, 20 mm are placed centrally, one above the other in descending order. Mean to say there are three cubes. Cubes means you should know. The cube of 60 mm means it is not only the base 60 by 60, the axis length is also 60. Not only the base, but the height also will be of the same size dimension. So cube, there are three cubes. One cube is 60 mm, second cube is 40 mm, third cube is 20 mm. He says these three cubes are placed one above the other centrally. Centrally means the 60 mm top face 60 mm center point and 40 mm bottom face center point should be in line. It should be matching. So it is placed centrally like that. Okay. So I'll show you how to do. He wants it to be in descending order. Descending order means reducing in scale dimension, reduction in scale dimension, and we all know we have to build the house from the base. Mean to say, we have to do the construction. Ground floor we have to construct. After that, first floor. After that, we are going to go for second floor. Mean to say, descending order should be from the base. Mean to say, first you have to place 60 mm, then 40 mm, and then top it is 20 mm. So how to solve this problem? Just check out. I'll show it to you in the software. Okay. So solid edge software. Now cube of first 60 mm sides, then 40 mm sides, then 20 mm sides. So let us construct 60 mm cube. So I'll start from base here. What are the angles we are supposed to remember? 30 and 150 degree, correct? So 60 angle 30 60 angle 150 60 angle minus 150 60 angle minus 30. Okay, what is the axis length? Axis length also it should be 60 itself, correct? So once I get this, except this line, I select the entire bottom face, go to move command, switch on the copy option. This point should overlap with this, okay, and then connect each and every corner from here to here, one line, from here to here, one more line. So after doing so much, don't leave it like this itself. If you leave it like this, you will start getting confused which is top face and which is the bottom face. To get that clarity, always remove the lines which are entering into the solid in the bottom face. So this is a bottom face, this is outer, this is outer. This is the line which is entering into the solid. So delete this line and delete this line. When you do this, you will understand which is the top face and which is the bottom face. Okay. After you do this, get the midpoint of this solid. I said midpoint, you should not draw diagonal lines. You should draw edge midpoint to opposite edge midpoint. One line is enough. Because in the cube, this line's midpoint will be the midpoint of the cube. Okay. If you want to check, I'll draw it one more line. Midpoint of any line will be the midpoint of a cube in the top. Okay, so I have constructed one line, that is more than enough. Now on top of this, you want 40 mm cube. So 40 mm cubes are created separately. So 40 angle 30, 40 angle 150, 40 angle minus 150, 40 angle minus 30. Okay, get the midpoint of this midpoint to this midpoint. Select the entire thing. Go to move command. Switch on the copy option. Let the copy option be on. Put this exactly in the center of the top face. So you should get the midpoint symbol. Okay, this face midpoint should fall on the top face midpoint because it says place the centrally one above the other. So this top face center should be the next face center. So delete this lines, not required. Go back to line command, increase the axis length. Axis length is height 40 mm cube, height is also 40. Then select this entire thing, go to move command, switch off the copy option. Here I have drawn the vertical line, so straight on top of it I have to place it. Then draw vertical line from here to here, one vertical line, then from here to here, one more vertical line. Now delete the bottom face innermost line. So this bottom outer, this portion has gone inside the solid. This portion also it has gone inside the solid. It's not only that, the 60 mm top square face, this line and this line has gone inside. So using trim command, trim off this line. This one, and this one. Okay. Next, on top of this, you have 20 mm square. Go back to line command. Do 20 angle 30, 20 angle 150, 20 angle minus 150, 20 angle minus 30. Okay. Get the midpoint of this, center to opposite edge midpoint. Select this. Go to move command. Switch on the copy option. This midpoint should fall on this midpoint. Okay. After that, go back to length command. Axis length is 20. Type 20 angle 90. Then later, delete these lines to avoid confusion if you want. Select the entire thing. Go to move command. Copy option I don't require. This base corner should fall on tip of. Okay. After that, draw a line, vertical line. From here to here, one vertical line. Then from here to here, one more vertical line. Then bottom face, outer. This is inner. This is inner. Trimmed. And this top face, inner line, this has gone inside the solid. This is inside the solid. This is inside the solid. This is inside. Done. This is what the question is. Three cubes of 60 mm, 40 mm, 20 mm placed one above the other in descending order. Place this of one above the other centrally. You can see here. Three cubes of side 60, 40, 20 are placed centrally one above the other in descending order. Okay? Of their side. So this is what we have done it in the software. Okay? So here, one more thing I wanted to tell you. Here, if you open your sketchbook and if you see the isometric sheet, the lines which have gone at an angle 30 degree, I ask you to place your protractor and measure the angle. At one particular point, I ask you to place the protractor and measure the angle, and you would have done. The angle says it is 30 degree and 150 degree, correct? And when I said if it is 40 mm square, you have to just count four number of boxes. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, mark the second point. 1, 2, 3, 4, mark the third point. 1, 2, 3, 4, mark the fourth point. 1, 2, 3, 4, mark the first point. Like that, I have said you. But now, I hope that you have understood whatever the concepts I have taught. Now, I wanted to introduce one more point here. The point is, we take your scale, go to your planes and solids sheet that you have worked. Place your scale in the box and check what is one single box count. One single box count is 10 mm. Correct. One single box count is 10 mm. If two box count is 20 mm, three box count is 30 mm. Like that it is there. Same thing, you check out in your isometric sheet, you keep your scale along the line which is inclined and try to measure the length of that box. If you see, the length of the box is not 10 mm, length of the box is 8.16 mm. Length of the box is 8.16 mm, it is not 10 mm. Okay, then you are telling, sir, why you are, when it is 8.16 mm and when it is 40 mm sides, why are we not taking the actual length? Why are we counting the boxes? If you ask, the answer from my side is, if you see, 1 minute, I'll stop the recording. Let us not